I'm Matthew Kiernan, the Bushell Chair of Neurology at the University of Sydney. I'm a consultant neurologist at Royal Prince Alfred Hospital and co-director of the Brain and Mind Centre here at the university. My area of research is looking at how the brain works, but particularly in terms of brain aging, so neurodegenerative disease. And my particular focus has been on dementia, neurodegeneration, and particularly motor neurone disease. So these are conditions that affect people in the prime of their adult lives, and unfortunately, they are universally fatal conditions. And we haven't been able to come up with effective therapies, and in part that's because we don't understand the disease mechanisms themselves. So the focus has really been on trying to unlock the condition. And in a way, in the course of my life, the understanding of these conditions has accelerated such that now we're starting to introduce treatments for patients diagnosed with these conditions. Other neurology conditions such as multiple sclerosis, when I started, there were no therapies. And fortunately, because of research, we've now got 13 or 14, you know, therapies which are registered in Australia for the treatment of multiple sclerosis. And hopefully we can come up with more therapies for neurodegenerative disease and dementia. It really is the holy grail. I'm extremely honoured to receive the Ramaciotti Medal. And it's something that I was nominated for by my colleagues, and it was judged by other leaders in the field. So it's really a recognition of the work that's been undertaken. And I suppose this is very much a team approach. So we're part of a multidisciplinary team. Discoveries aren't done by one individual. We have a large team of workers coming together, and that's engineers, nurses, allied healthcare workers, physio, occupational therapist, neuroscientists. We've got structural brain imaging. We've got people who are focusing on biomarkers, genes involved, and also with basic pathology. So for those patients who unfortunately have succumbed to the disease, they've been very generous in donating their brains and spinal cords to try and pursue understanding of the disease. The Ramaciotti Medal is something that I'd always heard of, and in fact some of my mentors had received it in the past, and so to receive that honour now is really, it's fantastic. I think the first issue was whether to do medicine, and I suppose I had a bicycle accident as a schoolboy, and that gave me an interest in looking at how doctors and nurses and medicine works in general, and that was the key for me pursuing a career in medicine. Then in the early 1990s, George Bush Sr. declared the 90s as the decade of the brain, and it seemed like a really exciting frontier. Discovery of, you know, new structural imaging approaches, magnetic resonance imaging, the genes of the brain, and really the brain hadn't been discovered, whereas other, you know, systems, cardiology was quite well understood, respiratory, gastro, surgery. Really, neurology was the final frontier, and in fact, we still don't know so much of how the brain functions and how we all work as human beings. I was fortunate to get an NHMRC fellowship to go overseas and work at the National Hospital for Neurology and Neurosurgery in London at Queen Square, and that really gave me a grounding in everything to do with neurosciences, and that included neuropsychiatry and really the dualism of the brain and the mind. And then bringing that back to Australia, being able to, you know, take off in my own field and have my own practice in neurology as well as an academic focus. And more recently, as editor-in-chief of the Journal of Neurology, Neurosurgery and Psychiatry, that's been a sort of a global initiative, understanding all of the research across clinical neurosciences. So I've been very lucky to have these experiences, and I think the more that you do in medicine and all fields of medicine, the more experience you have, the more enjoyable it becomes and the more understanding you get. So I've been very lucky over the course of my life to have many mentors and advisors, but I suppose really the best part of my research has been undertaking the work with a really fantastic group of PhD students who've worked with me over the years and have taught me so much in neurology, in medicine, and in life in general. I think medicine and research is very much an apprenticeship type of process. I was very fortunate to have great teachers who showed me a generosity of spirit. They took me aside and taught me how to do various things. And with that, I'm very keen to pass those skills on that I've learned. And really, as I said, we need large teams to approach this, and we need people who are enthusiastic and bring new ideas to the table. And the you know, people who are just starting off in their fields have the most exciting ideas, and we want to use their enthusiasm and skills to come up with better treatments. I've been incredibly fortunate over the years to have fantastic PhD students, and a number of them now are professors in their own fields, in their own right. And it's been great to see that journey going from a, you know, basic research approach through to specialising in the field, treating patients, and then developing their own research interests and teams. And I think that that's really a great highlight that we've all been part of as a teaching journey and an experiential process. So the thing that really, I suppose, drives my research is that I'm a practicing clinician. So today we've just finished a clinic. We've had about 25 patients coming in with neurodegenerative diseases. And these are people who know that the disease is going to kill them. And it's a horrible discussion. It's very difficult. And what we want to be able to do is say that in a few years' time we have much better therapies, and so the diagnosis that we give someone in the future is much better than the diagnosis we're giving to someone today. It's a real struggle for patients and their families to deal with these debilitating and universally fatal conditions. And I think it's the onus on all of us to come up with much better therapies. And that's what gets me out of bed in the morning, is to try and come up with better treatments for patients. And I think on the science side, it's a journey to try and uncover and understand diseases. So that's really the key motivation.